I'm Kelly Royce. Yeah. I'm a chiropractor, and I've got a bunch of great ideas that I think that will help people, and I'd really like to share them.
You've done a lot of research.
Right. I've done tons of research.
Right. And you've gone way down some rabbit holes.
Yes. I'm in the den with the bunnies in my protective garment here that's stainless steel on the inside.
That's right.
And the hat is silver lined.
Because you are electromagnetic sensitive.
I am extremely sensitive.
Right. And so you have actual physical symptoms.
Yes.
When you are exposed to Wi-Fi or such like that.
Horrible. And sometimes not immediately, sometimes immediately. There are thousands of things that can go wrong in your physiology by being exposed to these man-made emissions.
Yeah. So almost any disease or any physical symptom could be actually caused by radiation. You don't even know it.
Yes.
Okay. So how do you protect from that?
There are three cardinal rules of protection that you need to know. Shielding, time, and distance. The shielding garments that I mentioned earlier, this is lined with stainless steel and this is lined with silver. You can shield your living environment. There is time that you want to spend away from the sources of these man-made emissions, and there is distance. You want to distance yourself from any tower, any structure, any cell phone, any cordless phone, any Wi-Fi, any laptop. It just doesn't go with the human.
And that's everybody, not just electromagnetic sensitive people. I mean, it's not good for you, right?
It's not good for you, me, the cat, or the tree.
Right, right. So we've got some information, resources on the screen right now. People can go to these websites, find out good stuff. Now, wait a minute. There's people like you who can't even work at a computer. You get sick from that, right?
Yes.
So how do they go to our websites?
Well, they can't even approach the computer. So please help them get this information into their hands. And please, you go to the website and you print out the telephone numbers and you print out the articles and you give this to them and support them.
Right. That's how they can really take charge of their health.
Yes.
Get that information. But you really do have to help them because they can't do it.
And it shouldn't cost someone their health or their privacy or their safety to exercise their rights. Please help and support them and yourself.
If they can't get to the computer, they don't know. So they do need a little access.
Yeah.
So thank you, Kelly. Great job. And your phone number is here if people want to do some consulting with you.
Yes. Or my voicemail.
You have tons of great research on this, and there's your P.O. box, and they can find you.
Yes.
Thank you.
This is Kelly Royce, and I'm a former grand juror in the County of Nevada. I served there from 2012 to 2015 and was called into action over the widespread corruption and malfeasance and misfeasance in offices of the public trust.
And there's a problem with public corruption and misconduct now, is there not?
Yes, it's extremely widespread, and it will continue to increase until we take action and complain and notify our grand juries and have them exercise their functions.
And how do we get them to do that?
We simply complain, as our duty is to warn our neighbors, and we can serve on the grand juries if you've been in the county for a year and don't have a criminal record. And so you would apply and learn about all of the different committees that you can serve on and ways that you can serve. And then you can interview and investigate your local officials. And the two most important functions of the grand jury are the accusation function, where you can remove a corrupt officer through that function. And then the indictment is when there is criminal activity, it's dealt with on the criminal level with the district attorney. And I don't have any experience there. Sorry.
Yeah. Why is it that we don't have better control over the malfeasance and misconduct of our officials? And why is the grand jury system currently not doing the job as it should?
Well, unfortunately, we have one available in each county, and in the California Constitution, Article 1, Section 23, each county is required to seat a grand jury from July of one year to June of the next year. And not enough people know about this. And so I have a desire to do the grand jury reawakening, and that we get together with our neighbors in Nevada, and that we wake them up and educate them and get them involved so that we can serve our people and so that we can stop this corruption before it becomes more epidemic than it is.
I guess my question was, why are the people who are on the grand jury not doing this job now?
We are all trained by the California Grand Jury Association in our respective areas, and we are advised of our duties and responsibilities and charges. And oftentimes, it's the elderly of the population. I was the youngest to serve at 49 and had a little different perspective, but it is super important to be made aware and to make others aware of things that you see going on in your county that you know are wrong. Police and peace officer misconduct, public official misconduct, your board of supervisors, your city council members, your planning commission, they all swore the oath to uphold and protect your rights and the California Constitution's protected activities.
Yeah, we see wrongdoing all the time in the newspaper, even personally sometimes. Even sometimes we're subject to abuse by our officials in one way or another. So I can go and I can get on, I can apply to become a grand jurist. How does that work?
You just have to be a member of the county for 1 year, and then you can apply and be interviewed and go into the training sessions.
And where do I apply?
You can apply to each of your local county seat. We'll have a grand jury located through the court system, the Superior Court of California. You become an officer of the court and are sworn in for duty.
So if I go to the courthouse, they could tell me how to sign up?
Yes. Okay. You can contact the cgja.org, California Grand Jury Association, with it's got a great library of public reports that are published on there, the best ofs. And so it'll kind of help you tailor and give you an idea of a template if any of what is in there applies to your situation.
And how old do you have to be?
I believe it's 18 to 21 in the different jurisdictions, and you have to be of voting age. What can we do? We can show up at our Board of Supervisors meeting for the public comment period. Gives each one of the people 3 minutes to voice your opinions, your concerns, and your call to action for your public servants. Board of Supervisors, City Council, Planning Commissions, these are all of the people that are in charge of your public money in an office of the public trust, and they need to hear from you.